Take one. How's it going, YouTube? Welcome back to another episode of Digs of the Day, episode 21. I'm your host, DJ Trix, and on this episode, as promised, we're going to get into some soundtracks, some movie themes that I've purchased the last several months, and I purposely waited till I got a good amount, which I think I have now, maybe about 20. It took me about 3 months to get, because obviously when I'm buying records, I'm only going to find maybe one or two or maybe no soundtracks that day. So I'm excited to get into them. Some of them I'll share a soundbite of, but a lot of them I probably won't, because some of the music's not really that catchy, but it's the movie itself, the reason why soundtracks or movie themes are highly collectible and very expensive sometimes. The first one I picked up was Better Off Dead. I love this movie, man. It's a John Cusack movie from, I believe, the 80s. You guys might remember it. It's got that kid on there going around saying, my $2, where's my $2? You guys remember that now, right? Good movie, man. If you've never seen it, check it out. I think this is the movie where the guy says, you got my $2. My $2. The paper route boy. Is this it? Better Off Dead? Yes, this is it. Check out the movie when you get an opportunity. Better Off Dead. Funny movie. And if y'all want to see another good John Cusack movie, look out for Say Anything and also The Sure Thing. I actually have all three of these movies on DVD. So like the way the A is upside down there on Better Off Dead. Picked it up for $1 at a Goodwill. Better Off Dead. I'll go ahead and share. We'll skip that one. We'll share the next one, hopefully. The next one I picked up was, oh yes, Tron by Wendy Carlos. The original movie Tron from the 80s. Man, I loved that movie when it came out. I remember when the movie came out, I actually had, let me show you here. I actually used to buy baseball cards. So here's a pack of those baseball cards right here. I don't remember where I got this at. And they're cool, man. Little Tron cards. Got the sticker there still. And the back had something you put together like a puzzle. So not only do I have the record, I also got the cards. Well, at least one pack of the cards. And I also have the movie. I actually should have brought the DVDs, huh? Put the DVDs on the side of the movie. That's pretty cool right there, huh? eBay it. Maybe you could buy a pack on eBay. Tron. Great soundtrack. Highly collectible. Very expensive. I believe I got this one for less than $10 because of the condition it's in. You see the wing wear there. But the actual LP itself is in excellent condition, and that's what I look for, is the actual LP. Even though I do want a good cover, but the album is in pretty good condition. Actually, it's probably smells like cigarette. That's the only thing about buying records, man, from other people. I don't smoke, so that pisses me up. Man, smells like straight cigarette. Tron, man, this is a good soundtrack. Man. How do you get rid of cigarette smoke, guys? If you ever get an opportunity, or if you ever have one of those miracle digging days and you see this album, pick it up. I've seen it going for as much as $60 before on eBay, so we'll go ahead and share a snippet of this movie. Tron, music by Wendy Carlos. Next one I picked up was The Blues Brothers. Yeah, I got this movie too. This movie's probably from the either early, 78. I was going to say early 80s or 70s. Cool movie. It's all right. We're on a mission from God. Yeah, that's what I think of when I think of this movie here, the soundbite. A lot of people sample, we're on a mission from God. So yeah, it is what it is. A lot of you guys know, John Belushi, right? He passed on, so had to buy this one, Blues Brothers soundtrack. Another one I picked up was Ooh, I wish this was a part one. Psycho 2. You know, the classic movie Psycho with the stabbing scene in the shower. The house in Universal Studios. If you guys ever been to Universal Studios, Hollywood, California, you know the house. Crazy movie right here. I was surprised to actually see this at a Goodwill. I know this record goes for about $30, so definitely had to pick it up. Pretty cool, man. Pretty cool to actually see this on. I'm looking for Phantasm. If you guys know the movie Phantasm, that soundtrack, I've seen it going for $400 for the LP. So that's the one I'm looking for now. Hopefully I'll find it for a dollar. Cycle 2. Let's go ahead and share a snippet of that one. Another one I picked up recently was Break-In. Good movie. I believe I got another one of these already. But good movie. This guy actually used to live in Wilmington, California. Michael Chambers. That's what I hear, at least. You know, classic, man. This record takes me back right here, man, to when Break-In and it's called B-Boying. B-Boys. But Hollywood got a hold of it and changed it to Break-In. For those of you guys who ever seen Beach Street, and or if you guys want to see a documentary, look up the breakdancing one. Dang, I can't remember offhand the name of it. B-Boy. There's a documentary about breaking. I'll put it in the below in the whatever you call that there. Good documentary about B-Boys. Oh, The Freshest Kids. Yeah, look up The Freshest Kids, and that's going to give you a little bit of history of breaking or B-Boying, what it's all about. But this is a good soundtrack right here. I hardly ever see it, so when I do, I mean, I see it for $20, you know. They reprinted it, but glad to have picked it up. I'll share a snippet of one of my favorite songs off this record called Reckless by Ice-T. Got the DVD too, had it for many years. Glad to have picked it up. Another one I picked up was The Sting 2, and I never seen this movie, but the reason why I picked it up is because Lalo Schifrin. I see Scott Joplin on here too, his name. That name rings a bell. So anything Lalo Schifrin you guys ever see, pick it up. He did Enter the Dragon, Boulevard Nights, The Sting 2, obviously, a lot of soundtracks. Just can't get them off, can't get them in my head right now. It's pretty late. I was actually laying down, ready to go to bed, and got in here and had to do this because I couldn't sleep. The Sting 2, I'm going to share a snippet of this album. Fantastic soundtrack there. Sting 2 again, Lalo Schifrin. Gonna definitely have to watch that movie now that I know the soundtrack is so good. Another one I picked up is music by Jerry Goldsmith. I know Jerry Goldsmith rings a bell. Papillon. This is the soundtrack to Papillon. Fantastic movie. Picked this one up for $9 a while back, so glad to have found it in the store in Torrance, actually. This is a classic movie right here. If you guys never seen Papillon, go ahead and look it up. That's how you spell it right there. This is a tight movie. I got the DVD. Jerry Goldsmith, fantastic music movie composer. I'll go ahead and share a snippet of Papillon. good all-around movie right there. Glad to have picked that one up. Another one I picked up was Brooke Shields as a child in Pretty Baby. Many of you may have seen it. Is it Louis Malet? Or Malice? Louis Malet, I believe, huh? Fantastic soundtrack. For those who like that New Orleans type jazz, you know, New Orleans, man, you talk about Dixieland. New Orleans jazz is where the birth of jazz, at least to me, just like how they say New York is the birth of rap. Well, I say New Orleans is the birth of jazz, and I love jazz, and especially Dixieland jazz, New Orleans jazz. So anything to do with that, I'm going to collect it. This is a very controversial movie. I actually got the DVD of this movie, too, and it's a movie about how Brooke Shields, I believe she's only 12 years old, and shows her nude in the movie, actually. This movie was made in 1978, so it's a very controversial movie. Many of you guys know, remember Brooke Shields. I remember, I'm in my 40s, so as a growing up as a teenager, man, everybody was in love with Brooke Shields. I mean, she did The Blue Lagoon and Endless Love and Pretty Baby, a lot of movies, and then she kind of disappeared. Her mom was very overprotective of her, but just so happened that she came on this movie, Pretty Baby, and showed herself nude in the movie at the age of 12 as a prostitute. So very controversial, especially nowadays. I mean, I don't think you'd be able to pull a movie off like that nowadays, at least I don't think so. But fantastic soundtrack. Anyways, I'll go ahead and share a snippet of Louis Malet's Pretty Baby. I'm the one who don't mind my name. The whining boy don't deny my name. Whining boy don't deny my name. Pick it up and jig it like a Stephen James. Good soundtrack. Glad I have picked that classic up. Another one I picked up was a classic movie, Stand By Me. I remember seeing this movie as a young, probably 13, 14 years old. Good movie. Kind of a trippy movie. About these boys are going out to see a dead body. Man, this is crazy, huh? Soundtracks, the movies, man. Some of these movies are just odd movies, man. I love the pictures in the back. Got the pictures of all the guys there. Great movie right there, man. Stand By Me. I know you guys know the songs on there, so I'll skip sharing any of that. It's got Get a Job, Lollipop, Yakety Yak, Mr. Lee, of course, Stand By Me, Come Go With Me. A lot of good songs. I picked it up for a dollar. Anytime you see Stand By Me, it's just a classic all-around feel-good 80s movie. Pick it up. Another one I picked up was another classic 80s movie. I love 80s movies, by the way. I've got Stand By Me on DVD, and also even got Pretty in Pink on DVD. Another great movie. Picked this one up about 2 months ago, and I was just like, whoa, when I seen this soundtrack. I got to show my wife this one. She likes this movie. Good movie. You guys know these actors right there. Molly Ringwald and what's this guy's name again? This guy comes on 2.5 Men right there. I can't remember their names offhand. I guess that's embarrassing. Andrew McCarthy. That's Andrew McCarthy. Played a good movie on a good part on Less Than Zero, if you guys ever seen Less Than Zero. And who's the other guy? Can't remember, man. You guys didn't have to quote me on that one. Oh gosh, how embarrassing. Good soundtrack anyway. Good movie. I don't think I need to share anything off of this. Got groups on there like New Order, The Psychedelic Furs. My friend seen it, he goes, oh, let me get that 12, let me get that LP, man. Where'd you get that at? I go, nah, man, I'm into 80s soundtracks, so Pretty in Pink, another classic one to pick up. Glad that I found that for a dollar. Woo! Next one I'm going to share is a classic, classic one. Y'all ready for this? Trouble Man, Marvin Gaye. I actually bought this one online because it's kind of rare to find this when you're out there digging. I know some of you probably find it all the time. But me, on the other hand, can't find it. And the reason why I got it, because there's a show out there called Needle Dropping. Some cats, I believe, from somewhere from the East Coast, man, dropping some jewels on their show on YouTube. Look them up, Needle Dropping. And they played this album, and I said, dang, I got to pick that up, man. I don't even know. I got, like, this many Marvin Gaye albums, and I don't got this one. Oh, I got it now. But when they played it on Needle Dropping, I go, dang, Trouble Man, I haven't even heard of that movie. Still never seen it, so that's bad on me, right? But I'll go ahead and share a snippet. There's actually a sample on here that Fresh Prince and Jazzy Jeff used on their first album. I'm going to share a snippet of Marvin Gaye, Trouble Man. Excellent album, like the pictures in the back. Actually, let me show you the album. When the album opens up, so that's pretty cool like that, huh? That's tight right there. Marvin Gaye, man. Marvin Gaye, good old Marvin Gaye, some good gospel soul music there. Trouble Man. Another one I picked up was, wish this was part one, it's Karate Kid 2. Actually, Karate Kid 2 might be better than part one, huh? Still got a shrink wrap on there, so I was excited about that. This one don't smell like cigarette. So actually, none of them smell like cigarette. The only one that smelled like cigarette in all these this bunch here was Tron. Gosh, man. Please, people, if you smoke cigarettes, don't smoke around your records. You're ruining them. Karate Kid Part 2. This is the one where they go to Okinawa. I don't have this one on DVD. I've got Part 1. I like Part 1 and Part 3. Part 2, my wife probably likes Part 2. But I grew up watching Karate Kid Part 1. I probably watched that movie 100 times in my life. Good movie, good story. Ralph Macchio, or is that how you say his name? Ralph Macchio. And of course, Mr. Miyagi, I can't pronounce his name. Pat, let's just say Pat. So I won't even try to pronounce his name. But cool to find this, man. Another classic, Karate Kid Part 2. Got it for $1 at a Goodwill. And it ain't every day you walk into a Goodwill and you see things like Pretty in Pink and Stand By Me and Karate Kid 2. Actually, I've bought these several weeks apart at different Goodwills in the greater Los Angeles area. So glad that I picked up Karate Kid 2. I remember that I was looking through some records or some other records, and some a younger girl and a younger guy, maybe in their mid-20s, were looking through records too. I don't know why sometimes they think it's cool to buy records, young people. They don't know nothing about records, but they want to start buying them all of a sudden. I don't know why, like it's a retro cool thing to do. And they're looking through them. I heard the girl say, Karate Kid? No way. And if she said Karate Kid, I kind of looked like, oh my gosh, Karate Kid. Please move the heck out the way so I could grab that record. So I got it. But she didn't know what she was doing, I guess. Another one I picked up was another classic, Flash Gordon. Look at the picture back there in the back. Hope the lights ain't blurring it. We'll take off the plastic so you can see it. Good album right here, Flash Gordon. Pretty tight movie. Actually, I don't even have the DVD of this. I think I had it. My mom used to record movies on video cassettes all the time. I think that's how we had it. We had like 600 video tapes of movies growing up. Movie bucks in our house, man. I'll tell you, we watch movies every day. So I know a lot about movies, but Flash Gordon's a good movie. Glad to have found the soundtrack. Picked this one up at the Goodwill too. Still has a price on there, $5.98 from another store, I guess. Yeah, right there. See? So glad to have found this one for 99 cents. I'm going to share a snippet of Flash Gordon. Album right there, man. Cool album. Another one I picked up was, I'm gonna just go ahead and throw this one in there, Orson Welles, War of the Worlds. Woo wee. And this is the controversial wow, look, they have the actual pods. For those who've seen the War of the Worlds that was produced by Steven Spielberg, that's a pretty good movie there. And they actually have the pods there. So they actually had the idea of the pods before the Tom Cruise movie. So that's pretty cool right there. We see the pod there. You see the pod there in the back. And Orson Welles' War of the Worlds was a radio. They had it on the radio, and people actually thought that this was, that we were really being invaded by aliens. People were really terrified because it sounded so real when he did that. See, it says fake radio war stirred terror. And it was, I wasn't born yet, so I don't know about it, but I've heard about it from older people that when that happened, people were terrified. So when I seen this album at the Swami, I go, dang, I gotta pick it up. Actually, I seen it again a couple months ago, and or a couple weeks ago, and I should have bought another one. But this one is in such good condition, and I got it for 50 cents from some Mexican girl. I was excited about it. I was like, man, dude, I'm gonna go home and play it. And you know what? I still ain't played it. And it's been about 2 months. That's just the way I am. I'll play it one day. Actually, I'm gonna play it right now because I'm gonna share a snippet of Orson Welles' War of the World.
We know now that in the early years of the 20th century, this world was being watched closely by intelligences greater than man's, and yet as mortal as his own. We know now that as human beings busied themselves about their various concerns, they were scrutinized and studied, perhaps almost as narrowly as a man with a microscope might scrutinize the transient creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. With infinite complacence, people went to and fro over the earth about their little affairs, serene in the assurance of their dominion over this small, spinning fragment of solar...
Scary, scary stuff there, man. Be some good stuff to sample up for Halloween and put some drums or beats over behind that, huh? That'd be tight. Orson Welles, War of the Worlds. Another one I picked up was... Oh, man, classic movie. This movie I used to watch all the time. Lalo Schifrin's Boulevard Nights. Woo-wee, man. Classic, classic movie about the Chicano barrios, cholos. Check out the pictures there in the back. That is banging right there, boy. Banging. And I actually bought this one offline or online because I've never seen it anywhere I've been digging at. And I do a lot of digging. I go to a lot of record spots and I've never seen it. So actually, I don't even know they had soundtrack, but I started, when I started having in mind to put this show together with soundtracks, I've started saying, would it be a good soundtrack to share? Let me see if they have a soundtrack for this movie. Let me see if they have a soundtrack for that movie. And I actually came across this one. I said, man, I gotta buy this one to share it. Boulevard Nights has some really good music. Again, Lalo Schifrin, never knew that he actually had anything to do with producing this LP or the soundtrack to it, as along with George Benson. I'll go ahead and share a snippet of Boulevard Nights.
On the street, a child is born.
Tight, tight movie right there. This movie changed my life as a child, man. Lastly, another fun, feel-good 80s movie. Girls Just Want to Have Fun. If you guys know this one, DTV. About a dance show. Cool movie, man. My sisters used to always watch it in the 80s. So when I seen this one, I go, dang, Girls Just Want to Have Fun. I never knew they had a soundtrack to this movie. I had to pick it up. Got it for a dollar at a Goodwill and about three cities away. In excellent condition. I've seen this record going for a pretty penny, too. Glad to have picked it up. Girls Just Want to Have Fun. I don't think I have to share anything off of here. It's kind of 80s music, but glad to have picked it up. And again, you know, just excited. This stuff makes me excited in a good way, not in a bad way. It keeps me motivated to... search for music that I was never aware of or that I never knew existed and I've been waiting my whole life to hear. You know, stuff like this stuff, you know, Boulevard Nights or the Orson Welles, War of the Worlds, Trouble Man, Pretty Baby, Papillon, Tron theme. To actually watch the movies and experience the movies and then to sit there and listen to the soundtrack, whole different atmosphere, whole different setting. Whole different experience, and that's what it's about with music, is creating an experience and an enjoyable atmosphere and a clean atmosphere. And that's why most of these are clean, feel good family type movies. I'm very cautious of what movies I watch in my house, and I hope you are. So most importantly, stay digging if you're a digger. If not, we just encourage you to tune in and learn. If you have any questions about these LPs, feel free to comment below or message me personally. If there's anything that you want to share, feel free to comment below. We appreciate everybody's input. Got some good input, some good feedback on some of these Digs of the Day episodes I've done. And I'm not looking to get millions of hits. I'm just looking to share and grow and watch what other people share. A lot of other people are into posting records like this, and they do it for fun. They do it out of a passion because they're passionate about record digging, or they're passionate about music like this. And that's why I went out of my way to do movie themes, part one. Obviously, these are all movie themes right here I got. And those I bought a long time ago, so I won't share it. Stuff like Annie and, you know, and Crush Groove and stuff like that. Your basic movie stuff, you know, Star Wars. I got like four Star Wars, all the Star Wars LPs. Not all of them, but about four different ones. Star Trek, you know, things like that. Close Encounters, 2001 Space Odyssey. Things like that. But these ones I just picked up and I was excited to share with you guys. Thanks for tuning in. I'm DJ Trix, Digs of the Day episode 21. I take on movie soundtrack themes. And I'm just thankful to have people watch and continue to watch. And as I continue to do the best that I can to share the best records I picked up, man. You guys have a good day. See you again.